when I'm not collecting things, I like drawing them and painting them into the artwork. It's just something about seeing different materials from different times that I like capturing. And I think that's how it plays in my artwork, those details that tell a narrative of times gone by. It began with my mother. As a toddler, she gave me crayons and let me draw my walls from the crib. And then in high school at some point, I think it was trigonometry that did it to me. I said, I really don't want to do anything but go to art school. So I got out of college and I had taken puppetry. I'd studied puppetry in New York with Bill Baird. So then I became a soft sculptor and puppet artist. Did that for about 10 years working in fiber and then moved to Boston and realized I just wanted to draw again. And then I began my illustration career. I have always been interested in portraying people in one form or another. I'm drawn to capturing the details or the essence of a person. That's the consistent. If you look at my characters from my years as a soft sculpture artist, they're like what I'm painting now. The majority of my paintings are imaginary. So I start out with a sketchbook and a pencil and I draw from my imagination. Sometimes I do specific people like Frida or Louise Nevelson or the artist I'm doing on the cow now for the Jimmy Fund. But generally I like to work from my head. So whether it's the tattoos, the hair, the glasses, whatever kind of just reveals a little bit about who they are. I just love relics of the past. And I just started collecting. It's never gone away. This love of the vintage, this love of the antique, this love of old things. To me, the way you decorate the space that you live in is like creating a piece of art that you can step into. It's an installation, and I'm within it. I'm very nostalgic. So I can put myself back in time and place very easily and remember the color and the texture and the feel of a time and the objects that you surrounded, the clothing, the visuals. Vividly remembering those kinds of details is what comes to play in my artwork. The process of making art is just so enjoyable to me that I can't not do it. I don't really have to be inspired to be creative. It's something that's, I think, in your blood. You either are creative or you're not particularly, and it's just a compulsion. I have to do it. And I like challenges, and I like the hustle of doing what I love to do, but then finding success in doing that. What inspires me is maybe things I've seen or people that I've seen, but it doesn't inspire me to be creative. It's just something that I have to do. I just am. I can't not do it. I think art is important overall. Art gives us life. Art breathes life into the ordinary. There's a quote from Picasso that it washes away the dust of day-to-day life or something along those lines. And it kind of elevates. It's, can you live without art? Yes, you can live without art, I suppose. Can you live without the pleasure that art brings, without everything that art adds, be it paintings or sculpture or music? I don't think it would be a very happy existence. So I think art is essential to a life well lived.